Hi, welcome to Science Time at Questacon. My name's BJ.
I'm Dion.
And today we're talking about flowers and spring. Come and join us.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time.
Welcome to Science Time. Who can tell me what we're talking about in Science Time today?
Flowers!
We're talking about flowers and springtime. Who has flowers growing in their gardens at home? Yeah? Yeah, or maybe your neighbour's garden? My neighbour has beautiful flowers in their garden. Yeah? Oh, fantastic. Hands down. Now, it's springtime now. Here in Canberra, we have a beautiful spring. What's the difference between winter and spring? It's not winter anymore, is it? No. How do we know it's not winter anymore? What's the difference? Because it's hot. Well done. Winter's very cold, and the sun is out now in the springtime, and it's getting nice and warm, isn't it? Also, have you noticed the leaves on the trees are starting to grow again? So the leaves are growing and the flowers are growing. I love springtime. Now, what do flowers need to help
water,
them grow?
Water.
They need water, yep, from the rain, lots of water.
And sun.
And sun. They need sunshine as well, don't they?
And
yes. Yes, yes, absolutely. So, it all starts with planting a little flower seed in the dirt. The rain comes to give it water, the sun shines, and the plants start to grow. Has anyone here ever planted a seed in the ground and watched it grow? You have? Oh, that's so much fun, isn't it? Hands down. At home, you might like to plant some seeds and watch them grow. Really? And lots of times. Wow. Now, here we've got a bit of a flower to show you. This is a plastic flower, but it's really good. We can see all the parts of the flower. So first, the flowers at the top. Now, here are the pretty flowers. What are these little bits of the flower called?
The flower.
The sides, they're the sides of the flower. Yes, they are. Does anyone know what these are called?
Petals.
Petals, well done. These are the petals, and that's petals make up the flower. Now, what else have we got on our flower here? We need something to hold up the flower. What's? It's like a stalk, well done. Or another word for that is a stem. Can you say that word? Stem. So the stem holds up the flower. We've also got these parts of the flower as well. If you could hold this one for me, Dion. This one has long, thin ones. This one has kind of more round ones. What are these called? What are these?
Leaves.
Leaves. Leaves are very, very important. We'll talk about why in a moment. And down under here, this is normally under the ground. This is like a seed, or these big seeds are called bulbs. And bulbs, you might have planted bulbs before. Thank you, Dion. You have? Yep. And that's where the flower grows from. So the stem and flower grow up here, but something very important grows down into the dirt. What do you think these are? Where the flower drinks its water from. Well done. What are they called? Roots. They're called roots. Can you all say that word with me? Roots. Well done. And the flower uses its roots to suck up the water. Just like sucking up water with a straw. Have you ever used a straw to drink stuff with, yeah? And you have to suck really hard, like that. That's just like the roots. They suck up the water, and then the water goes all the way up the stem, all the way to the flower at the very top. So we need water, don't we, for the flower to drink, but we also need sunlight. And here we... They do get wet, don't they? Now the sunlight's very important. Do you know a plant uses its leaves to get energy from the sun? Just like the big sun outside, absolutely. So the leaves get energy from the sun and they use that energy to help the plant grow. There's a special word for that. It's called photosynthesis. Can you say that word with me? Photosynthesis. It's a big word, photosynthesis. It means getting energy from the sun to help the plant grow. Now, there's something else you might have seen in the garden. There's a little animal, a little insect that helps the flowers. Bees. Bees are in the garden too, and bees are very important for plants and flowers. Do you have some bees in your driveway, do you? Yeah? Oh.
Bees help things make honey.
Good girl. Hold on just a moment. Yes, yes, and you don't want to get too close to a bee because they can sting you, can't they? But you're right, bees make honey. Who likes to eat honey? Yeah, I love eating honey. And do you know what the bees do? They, inside the flower, there's a nice, sweet-tasting liquid called nectar. And the bees like to drink the nectar, and then they make honey. So, oh, bzzz, bzz, I think I hear a bee. Do you hear a bee? Bzzz. Oh, here's our Questacon bee. Would you like some nectar, bee? Here we go, lots of nectar in the flowers. Drink up. Yum. Now the bee is very, very important because not only does it drink the nectar, also inside these flowers there's something called pollen. Can you say that word with me? Pollen. And what happens is the pollen gets stuck on the bee's feet. As he's coming near the flowers, it'll get stuck on his feet. And he takes that pollen to other flowers. So bye, Mr. Bee, go and drink some nectar from the other flower. And all the pollen from his feet goes on to that flower. And by putting pollen from one flower onto another flower, that helps the flowers make new flowers. Yeah. So the flowers need the bee to help make new flowers. Thank you, Mr. Bee. Lovely. Bye. Bye, Mr. Bee. Lovely, lovely. So, in the garden, at home, see if you can see any flowers. You might see some bees near your flowers. And you're right, if you see a bee, should we touch it?
No,
because it could sting you, couldn't it? And you need to be very gentle with bees. Don't touch them.
You can call your mummy and daddy.
You can call mum and dad and that. If you did get stung by a bee, you'd go and see mummy and daddy or your grown-up straight away and they'll help you. Now, one last thing I want to show you. Have a close look at these flowers. Do you see the yellow in the middle of the flowers? Do you see how there's yellow there? Do you know the bee is attracted by that yellow colour, and that yellow colour tells the bee where the yummy nectar is. Right here in the middle of the flower. So the bee knows exactly where to go to get the yummy nectar. So flowers are beautiful colours, not just to look pretty, but also to help tell the insects where to go. It's a lovely flower, this one, isn't it? So we've got lots of things to play with here in Questacon today. Find your grown-up and go and have a play. Off you go.
Science time.
So while everyone else is playing, let's go have a look at some other flowers. Hi boys and girls. Here in Canberra, we're really lucky to have a massive flower show called Floriade. And here we are at Floriade, as you can see. Now, it's not as much fun coming here by myself, so I thought I'd invite BJ along. BJ!
Hi Dion, hi boys and girls.
Now, there are lots of flowers here at Floriade.
Lots and lots and lots of flowers.
But when do most flowers grow?
When do you think?
What do you think? Springtime, exactly. So that's why Floriade is held every springtime here in Canberra. Now, behind us, you can see lots of different types of flowers. What colours can you see? Have a look. There are white ones, blue ones, purple ones, yellow, and even red. There are lots of different types of flowers, aren't there? But you know what, BJ? I think we should go looking for some more.
There's lots and lots to look at.
Let's go.
Let's go.
So we've looked at so many flowers here at Floriade. What was your favourite, BJ?
The daffodils, I think.
Why is that?
I like the yellow sunny face. It looks good.
My favourite was actually the tulip.
What colour tulip? There's lots of different colours.
There were. Orange was my favourite.
Yes, yeah.
So we've looked at lots of flowers here at Floriade, and you can too. Floriade is here at Commonwealth Park in Canberra every springtime, and it's lots of fun. How about we go back to science time and see what everyone's up to?
Good idea, Dion. Well, we were playing with lots of flowers and plants today at Questacon Science Time. There's this couple of special plants here that I want you to have a closer look at. Now, these plants are what we call carnivorous. Can you say that word? Carnivorous. That means they get extra nutrients by eating insects. Yeah, so this is one you might have seen before. Does anyone know what this one might be called?
No.
A Venus. Venus flytrap. It's a Venus flytrap. And you see here, it's got these little bits that open up like that. Then the bee comes and stands on it and it goes whoop, just like that. So can you show me your Venus flytrap? And here comes the fly, close it up, whoop, like that. And then inside, the fly gets digested and helps give the plant yummy nutrients to make it grow really well. Now, this one is an exotic plant. This one doesn't live in Australia normally. It comes from America, North America, this one. Now, here's another carnivorous plant. This one comes from Asia. It's called a pitcher plant. This one works a little bit differently. Here, the insect goes down into here, and inside here, there's some yummy, juices. There's some juices that digest the insect and help give the plant lots of nutrients. But you see, they have leaves as well, don't they? So they still get energy from the sun. They still photosynthesize, but the insects give them extra nutrients to help them grow really well. Carnivorous plants. I like carnivorous plants. Thank you, Dion. Now, before we go today, we've got some stuff for you to take away with you. First, we've got our parent information sheet. Now, here's a bit of an information sheet, give you some ideas of some activities to do, some websites to look at. At home, you can download this from our website and have a look at it at home. We've also got one other thing as well. Thanks, Dion. Here we've got our colouring in picture. Now remember, flowers can be lots of different colours, so you can choose any colour you like to colour these flowers.
And what are these things buzzing at the top here?
They're
bees. So the bees will drink all the nectar and take the pollen to all the different flowers. Now, but before we give them out, can you look at the boys and girls at home for me? Can everyone look over here? Can we wave and say, see you next science time?
See you next science time.
Fantastic. Come and get a colouring in picture. Here we go. Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.